Hey guys! Welcome back to Art Class with Miss Clark. I am so excited for this project today because it is using a material that we probably have a lot of right now. Well, I know my house has a lot of it right now. We have a lot of cardboard. So we have a lot of cereal boxes, just a lot of trash around the house and, you know, getting a lot of packages to the house because we're not allowed to leave. We have a lot of cardboard and it's kind of just sitting around. And so I figured, what better way to use that cardboard than to make an art project out of it? We are doing an art project inspired by the super famous artist. His name is Pablo Picasso. A lot of you have probably heard of him. He is considered a master in the arts. He is one of the leaders that paved the way for the art movement called Cubism. Cubism is a really famous art movement that was in the early 20th century. This came on the scene when the classic painting was abandoned. So cubism is when you divide up whatever you're drawing into different shapes, geometric shapes, different layers, a lot of different interlocking planes, a lot of abstracts. A lot of the times in cubism, you don't know exactly what you're looking at. Sometimes it's easier to recognize than other times, but usually the objects or people that whatever's in the painting is separated into geometric shapes. It looks very cubic. Hence the word cubism. This was a very revolutionary thing in Europe in the early 20th century because painting was considered this very high level job and career, and someone who could paint realistically and could paint in an accurate perspective, that was really highly valued. That's why we see a lot of paintings from the monarchy, kings and queens, because they were wanting to be painted accurately. They were wanting to be painted in all of their glory with all of their riches. They wanted to be remembered. So when this art movement came on the scene, it was very different. People didn't like it. People were very unsure of it. Nowadays, it's a very well-known art movement, and Pablo Picasso is a Spanish painter. He was one of the people that paved the way for this art movement. He created a lot of works of art within this art movement, and actually within his lifetime, people didn't really like his art. And so his art wasn't that liked when he was alive, which I would think that would be really hard. You know, if you're spending all your time doing something and no one likes it, it's awful, right? So we are going to be making a relief that is inspired by Pablo Picasso. So I encourage you to make a face. You can make anything that you want, but we are going to be primarily making a relief. A relief is different than a sculpture. A sculpture is something that you can see all the way around. So you can view it in 360. So that means any viewpoint that you stand in looking at the sculpture, you see all the details that are sculpted. A relief, it means that you view it from the front. So if you were to flip it over and view it from the back, it would just be flat. So the sculpture, it's slightly raised. It's not sculpted in the round. It's just sculpted enough to be raised and to have enough detail and to have that value and that depth in the artwork, but it's not enough to be a full-on sculpture. When we're starting with our cubism face, something that we need to focus on is proportion. So painters in the olden days, they were highly regarded painters because a lot of the time they painted proportions accurately. Cubism is the opposite. So cubism is known for having very non-proportional facial features on the face. When you are making your eyes, your nose, your mouth, sometimes one eye is up here, one eye is down here. Sometimes the nose has a big long line. A lot of Picasso's artworks show this. And sometimes there's two different sides to the mouth. Maybe the mouth is only on one side. Picasso experimented with putting his facial features in different areas of the face, making them different shapes. Maybe one eye was square, one eye was circle. There's no defined limit to this. There's no right way, there's no wrong way. Just whatever feels right and whatever looks right to you is perfectly fine. First thing you're gonna do is you're going to cut out a shape that's going to be the base. So you need a base to start on. When you have your base, you're going to then build on top of the base. Every facial feature will then be a layer. And so the goal is to have as many layers as you can. The eye will be one layer, and then you'll add another layer of the iris, which is the colorful part of your eye. And then you can add another layer of the pupil. You can add a big long line for the nose. You can experiment and make it any way that you want. So the things that you are going to need for this art project is cardboard. You're gonna need some sort of glue, tape, something where you can stick all of your pieces of cardboard together. And you're obviously going to need scissors to cut out your cardboard. I'm gonna start out by cutting out the base of my face. So as you can see, my vase is very asymmetrical. So what that means, if I were to cut it down the middle and I were to fold it in half, both sides won't line up. This side looks different than this side. So that's what asymmetrical means. I have my base. I'm then going to start out cutting out facial features to then place on top of my base. So as you can see, I'm using different shapes for my eyes, and that is totally okay. You can also do your eyes in different areas of the face. So if one eye's up here, it's totally okay. If one eye's down here, you can play with it and you can make it look however you want. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start adding more layers. So I'm gonna start adding the iris and the pupil and maybe a highlight. I'm going to start building up those layers so my face starts to look more like a relief. What that means is if you look at it from the side, you'll start to see it become slightly raised. So once I feel happy with the eyes, I can start to move on to other facial features such as the eyebrows and the nose and the mouth, and you can add ears, hair, whatever you like. Happy with all of the different shapes that you have and all of the different facial features you have. So if you notice, I only included the eyes, the eyebrows, the nose, a nostril, and the mouth. So once you feel like you're done with this, you can then start to color it. So you can color it with colored pencils, you can use markers, you can use paint. I'm personally gonna use paint because I have a lot of it, but I know not a lot of people have paint at home right now. So you can use different art materials. You can even color it with straight up pencil if you don't have anything else. Or you can leave it as just a cardboard relief because you get to see some of these different tones in the cardboard, and that starts to look really cool as well. Variety of colors and the variety of shapes really start to come through, and you can start to see each individual facial feature start to pop out and be evident and obvious. Definitely encourage you to use a variety of shapes. Shapes is an element of art, so it is just two-dimensional squares, triangles, hexagons, octagons, all that fun stuff, all these different types of shapes. Use different shapes with the cardboard to make your facial features, and don't be afraid to layer multiple shapes on top of each other. That gives it interest and that gives it the dimension that a relief has. Use a variety of colors. So if you want to use color scheme, you can do cool colors on one side, warm colors on the other, or you can just use variety of colors randomly. It's a really cool piece of artwork, you know, when you use really bright, vibrant colors. It's very cubist, very Picasso-like. That's all from me. I hope you enjoyed making cubist cardboard faces. Join me next time on Art Class with Miss Clark.